This is the main reason I find the PNP to be repulsively disgusting. After the strong economic development of Jamaica in the 1950s and 1960s, it was the PNP that reversed our economic fortunes in the 1970s, losing 25% of the value of the economy. The Jamaica Labour Party had the hard work of restoring the economy to economic growth, and gave back the economy to the PNP, growing at 6%. That's a fact. That's our reality. It can only be mismanagement that after nearly 20 years of the PNP, the Jamaican economy has been damaged, and the damage was a significant one. The disgusting thing is that they are trying to deceive the people, insulting our intelligence. Now, they have the audacity to be blaming the JLP for the condition of the economy. They have the gall to be talking about Jamaica having the worst macro economy in the world. They do this with no regard to the global economic situation since 2008 and with no regard to their own contribution to the state of affairs, as if they created a strong economy. Can you believe that? How dishonest. How did we get here? How? When? How did Jamaica get to this position? When did it start? These are important questions the PNP must tell Jamaica. Mr. John Jackson, financial analyst, spoke to this in an interview on Nationwide discussing the debate on the economy.
What I find disingenuous about the entire debate, and more so from the standpoint of Dr. Phillips, is that statements have been just been made and there's no evidence to support it. I mean, you look at the gross domestic product growth from 2001 to 2007. It's 1.6% growth per annum in that particular period. Anemic at best when you had better opportunities. One of the things that I find is that the background against which the country is operating has not been really mentioned. And that has a lot to do with what has taken place, certainly since 2008. And if you don't put the thing in that context, you keep just looking at numbers and performances, you may come to the conclusion that the country has been terribly managed. But in choosing, in fact, when you compare it to what has taken place and what has taken place elsewhere in the world, it stands up fairly well. And in choosing, in fact, the government got a basket to carry water in 2007. Debt to GDP, fiscal deficit was about running about 8 to 9% at the time they took it over. The debt, yes, was 108%, but when you take that level of deficit, it's going to cause the thing to escalate because you have to make choices. Do you raise revenue instantaneously?
Hear you, John.
To close the fiscal gap. And in choosing, in fact, the government got a basket to carry water in 2007.
You can listen to a party that is hungry for power and will say anything, any thing, to return to office. Or you can listen to an objective financial analyst. It would be to Jamaica's best interest to keep the People's National Party in opposition. It would be an injustice if they were ever elected again,